Hello, and today we are with Mr. Roland Aung, who is the hotel manager of Mode Sathorn Hotel.
Yeah, right.
Good morning to you, Roland.
Good morning, Steven. How are you?
Very well, thank you. Now, here we are at the ASEAN Tourism Forum 2015. How has the show been for you so far?
Yeah, it's good. Since for today's the last day, I've been here since yesterday. Yeah, it's doing well.
Have you signed much business?
No, we don't do yet. Mostly the talking and discussing.
Where is most of the interest coming from for here at the show?
The market that we are looking at, the European and the Australian market. Yep.
Now, Mode Sathorn, of course, a lot of people know Sathorn, but tell us about your hotel. What is it? What makes your hotel unique?
We are quite new, just 1.5 years ago, under the operation. It's on the Sathorn Road. It's very convenient to travel around Bangkok. It's a 201 rooms, 38 floor building. It's under the Surasak BTS station. It's very easy to travel around Bangkok. Okay, we have the rooftop restaurant and 3 outlets. Yep.
How have you broken up the different room categories of the hotel and how do they differ?
Yeah, we are different on the design. When you reach the hotel, the thing you clearly see is on the category of the room. We have the deluxe room, but with a different floor design. That means you see, if you go to the usual hotel, you will see, if it's a deluxe room, you will see all the rooms are the same design, but we have 4 different design. If you look at on our cities, you will see more clearly, we have the different design, and then the guests can come back for at least 4 times and they can experience our rooms.
Now, of course, Bangkok has had a bit of a turmoil year in 2014.
Yep, you're right.
How did you end the year in terms of average room rates and occupancy? How did the year progress last year? Yeah,
the progress, you see, it's quite slow during the first half of the year, and later on it's picking up. Let's say last 4 months, since from September, the last quarter is doing well. We did well around above 89 occupancy, and then this year is doing all right also. January is quite full already, February is quite full, but March onwards we have to look at it again.
In terms of your guests, what are your top 5 nationalities at the hotel, and did that change throughout the year last year with all the different turmoil going on?
It's a little bit changed. Nowadays, the Asian traveler, the short haul are quite climbing a lot. Mostly we receive from Hong Kong, Taiwan, Singapore, also some from Japanese. Yes, it's changed a little bit because the short haul people traveling quite a lot.
Now, you're an independent hotel.
Yeah, you're right.
Do you have any plans to join an alliance or anything such as that?
We used to be under the CMSCM Design Hotel. It's managed by CMSCM Design Hotel. It just finished the contract last year, let's say around end of August. And then we decided to run by ourselves as an independent hotel.
And how is that going for you?
It's doing well.
What is the advantage and disadvantage of working with, let's say, an alliance or a group compared to working independently?
Okay, there's a pro and con everywhere, right? Okay, if you do with a group, you may have the, what you call, it's good on the system and the standard because you get it from the group, okay? But once you became an independent, it's easier to make the decision and changing the new rate strategy and whatever. When you need to adjust, you need to do ask a permission from the group. We just do it ahead. You can do a little bit quicker, that's all.
Now, in terms of the guests, of course, all guests now have multiple devices. They need internet. Some hotels charge still, some don't. Yep. What is the policy at your hotel?
For the internet, internet is essential things for the industry already, Steven, and this is it should be free of charge everywhere.
How else are you using technology to improve the guest experience? Do you, for example, are you using any online check-ins or anything such as that? Or do you have any plans to use technology in that way in the future?
In the future, we are thinking about it. Of course, it's applied to the country law also, the immigration law and the Interior Ministry of Law, whether when you still need the paper or not. Because of the signing, the digital signature is not allowed yet at the moment.
In terms of the travel trade shows that you'll be attending, which travel trade shows will you be attending this year?
Usually our hotel is joining all the big trade shows such as WDM and ITB, and our director of sales and marketing attending over there.
For your owners at the hotel, do they have any plans to build any or open any other hotels under the Mode brand?
We have a plan in the future, but I'm not sure in Bangkok or not, but it should be in the app country. Let's say Pattaya and onwards.
Yep. So you're looking at the major tourism areas?
Yep.
And do you have any idea of a time frame for that?
Sorry, Steven?
Do you have any idea of a time frame? Do you know when that might happen?
At the moment, it's on the project. We have the land already, but it is on designing process.
Excellent. Okay, well, in that case, I have to say, Roland, thank you very much indeed for your time today. And of course,
thank
I wish you
Steven.
And the Mode Sathorn Hotel the best of luck in the future.
Thank you, Steven.
Thank you.
Have a nice day. Take care.
You too. Thank you. Bye.